nature's wealth, good for your health. This is the Raw Life Health Show. Hello, everybody. Here we are with one of my favorite guests, Nurse Tom. Nurse Tom has been a teacher at Hippocrates Health Institute. He has a wonderful private practice now. But the thing that's most exciting is he's gotten cured from a stage 4 cancer. Mm-hmm. And he's going to tell you about his story, his recovery, and what you can do to either improve your condition or avoid getting these things. So, Nurse Tom, introduce yourself to the people who haven't met you yet, the people who have, say hello.
Absolutely. Well, glad to be here, Paul. And, you know, what really got me into learning about natural health and functional medicine, integrative medicine, was, you know, way back 21 years ago, I was diagnosed with stage 4 cancer, a type of lymphoma. And back then, you know, I was your average American guy, ate lots of meat, lots of desserts and things like this. And I noticed, you know, I started to develop some fatigue back then. And I thought that was weird because I was a very athletic guy, played basketball to the collegiate level. So I was strong physically. And I started to notice discomfort. And the discomfort started turning the pain to the point where I actually went to the emergency room to figure it out. And then they ran lots of tests there. And they found basically a large mass in my chest region. And when they did more testing, they actually found out it was stage 4 cancer. And from there, I started to do lots and lots of research and started to see what type of food's going to help me, what type of supplements are going to help me, what type of exercise, what type of lifestyle changes that I needed to make. And as I did that, I started to learn more and more about vegan food, more and more about raw foods, and more about juicing and things that were really important nutritionally with various vitamins and nutrients to help my health. And with that, I ended up going to a health institute called Hippocrates. And there I learned more in depth about the raw and the living foods and using sprouts. And the reason that sprouts are so important is they are very high in phytonutrients. So when we're talking about foods that are anti-cancer, the form of broccoli, the mature form of broccoli plant, and compared to a broccoli sprout, the broccoli sprouts have 50 times more phytonutrients. So you're getting so much more anti-cancer nutrients. Now, the other thing that was really important with my recovery is alkalizing my body. And how did I do that? Well, I did it, of course, eating greens, but I also juiced vegetables, and I also juiced wheatgrass juice, and I also drank lemon water. Now, with that being said, when I'm talking about a pH, you can test that. You know, you can test your first morning pH. You want to see that urine pH between 6.4 and 7. When you do that, you know you're at a good level of alkalinity. The reason that's important is even from research, this is on PubMed, this is where medical doctors get their research. Landmark study in 2009 showed alkalizing the body can help to stop and or prevent the metastasis of breast cancer and liver cancer and lymph node involvement. So when we alkalize, we're supporting ourselves. But we're also adding in that other great thing called chlorophyll, which is in plants, especially more so in those green vegetables and sprouts. Now, chlorophyll is antifungal, antibacterial, antiviral, and anti-inflammatory and anti-cancer as well. So when you can start increasing that greens, you're starting to support yourself. Beyond that, there's different nutrients that are very supportive for your immune system. We have to get your immune system back when you have a condition like cancer because it's definitely either going to be suppressed or not functioning properly. We can use nutrients such as vitamin D3 with K2. When you optimize your levels of vitamin D with K2, you basically reduce your incidence of all cancer by over 50%. Beyond that, it's going to help your bone strength. It's going to support your hormones as well, even support cardiovascular health. So the D is extremely important. Beyond that, we can use other nutrients, such as zinc. Now, a lot of people know zinc is good for our immune system, but the other thing it does, especially if we have cancer, is it reduces our copper levels. Copper is a nutrient that promotes growth. So we don't want a lot of that when we're going through something like cancer. The other thing that a lot of people aren't aware of is a large part of our immune system's made in our gut. And with that being said, we want to keep your gut health extremely good. So in doing that, we can use things such as pure foods. We can use fermented foods like kimchi or sauerkraut. We can use probiotics, things like Acidophilus that populate our upper gastrointestinal tract, Bifidobacterium to populate that lower gastrointestinal tract. And obviously, we are what we absorb. So we want to work on our absorption. So that's where digestive enzymes can help us, along with chewing our food properly. And, you know, with that being said, the digestion is not the only thing the gut's doing. It's also helping to support our hormones. About 50% of your hormones are made in the gut and a large part of your neurotransmitters. So gut health is extremely important in your overall health. But one thing that I find to be extremely important with the clients that I work with is their mind-body health. Now, we can use things such as prayer. We can use meditation. But two of the things that I found to be very important are recall healing. This is based off of Dr. Hammer's work from Germany. And what they found when they analyzed 6,000 of his clients that had very advanced cancers, just using the mind-body therapy, 93% were still alive after 5 years. So after 5 years in medical, that's called a cure if you're alive. Now, beyond that, there's other electromagnetic therapies that are also very important. There's one from a biofeedback called Zyto, and it has a voice recognition software called Evox. And through your voice, it can pick out different emotions that affect your health and affect that are affecting you. And then it can also help to support balancing that. But the mind-body therapy with the recall healing can help to speed that up. And I see when people incorporate nutrition, lifestyle modifications such as incorporating exercise, especially aerobic exercise, because you want to get that oxygen in your system. And when we incorporate pure water, because unfortunately there's things in our water these days that are not good for our health, such as high levels of fluoride, which can actually be carcinogenic. And we can use filtration to get some of that stuff out of our life. And the other type of water that I like specifically is structured water. So structured water is a device that sends frequencies to the water. It changes its structure slightly, allows your body to hydrate 3 times better. You're going to get more energy. You're going to get more oxygen. And through the research, it's also anti-cancer as well. So there's many things that we can do to support ourselves, support our life, keep our immune system strong, and use natural therapies to support our healing, especially in something like cancer.
Great. If people want to get in touch with you, because you do coaching to help people with this, how can they do so?
Absolutely. They can reach me at livingrawsolutions@gmail.com.
Great. We'll put that below the video.
Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Anytime, Paul. Great to see you. Nature's wealth, good for your health. This is the Raw Life Health Show. Raw Life, brighten up your life.